Very good morning to you. Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. We're live, large and in charge, connecting with you on this Wednesday morning. And it's so good to be in your company. Thanks for joining us. Danny Kay, Kabelo Mabalane, joining us this morning. Two gentlemen who've proven themselves to be far more than just platinum-selling award-winning artists. They've conquered the music business, and now the pair joins us to let us know on how they've successfully transitioned into dominating not just the music industry, but doing the same in commerce as well. We seek inspiration from the two. Yeah. It's so great to have you here. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Danny Kay, Kabelo Mabalane in the studio.
It's a very hard ball. It's a very hard up and under. You just keep it for us.
You got it. Chess and Kobe style.
Guys, I mean, I did say earlier on, we appreciate having you guys here. And every single time I've seen the two of you guys together, we know that we're going to be left feeling so inspired and so motivated. Mm-hmm. Good news only. But we know that you guys obviously successfully, you know, led your careers in music, but of course transitioned into the world of business. Mm. How did the shift from business in that sense and then the commerce sense come about? How did that shift come about and happen for you guys?
You know, I read somewhere that the word entrepreneur actually is the French word for a creative.
Mm. All right.
So I think it stems from there, you know, making music, making TV, you know, and you create stuff out of nothing.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, that's embedded in the both of us to create, you know, something out of nothing. So whether you go into business or, you know, whatever, you know, field it is, it's always about creating new things, you know.
Mm. And Danny, has it always been the case for you? Because I mean, I remember when we did a gig together and you were speaking behind the scenes, you were sharing so much of your knowledge with some of the guys around there about the stuff that you're doing, helping them to connect dots as well. Has it just always been a part of you too?
Yeah, I mean, before I was a musician, before I had any career in music, I was working a 9-to-5 in an investment bank. So, you know, I came from, an academic background, found myself in the music business, but realized that some of the truths in both is that if you don't change with the times, if you don't move, educate, have great people with you, you know, careers can be very fleeting and short-lived. So everything I've tried to do over the in a span of my 20-year career in this business, he's been in this business even longer than me, I think requires, as you say, that creative entrepreneurial spirit. And actually what we're here to do today, funnily enough, is not really a commerce-driven project. It's more one about our country.
Yeah.
It's about us, I guess, being active citizens in our country and wanting the best for South Africa. And with the same real motive that we began Shout for a Safer South Africa, we want to play our part. And I think, you know, I think sometimes it doesn't always have to be about rands and cents, but to do really meaningful, good things, it has to come from an honest and true why, you know, why you're doing this.
Yeah.
And that's why our diversity project is, I think, doing as well as it is I think people can see our sincerity. I hope they can, and that's what's made it a success. Yeah.
Wow.
Well, you guys are obviously known for really spearheading this Shout initiative, which you guys have been able to carry through your celebrity status, and now you speak about the why around why you're running this, you know, initiative and campaign around diversity. Tell us more about the why of this diversity initiative you guys are working on.
Well, I mean, we believe that, you know, this country can realize the potential that it has, but it's not going to happen by us kind of sitting on the corner and not doing anything. You know, we've got to get into the playing field, roll up our sleeves, and do stuff, and sometimes not the nice stuff, because, you know, some of those issues that we deal with in our talk, initiative, you know, we deal with issues around racism, you know, stereotyping, unconscious bias, because once, if we don't deal with those roadblocks in our country, where if we're forever going to make, you know, stereotypes or believe in stereotypes that, you know, all people from, you know, from Pontievo, for example, are gangsters, or all Nigerians are drug dealers, then we're never ever going to have, you know, in Zulu they say ubudlelwane, you know, we're never ever going to have relationships, because we make foregone conclusions about each other that really land us up in trouble. Mm-hmm. So we use our relationship as a backdrop in terms of how we've navigated the choppy waters of this country, using personal experience, experiences of how racism, you know, has affected me in my life, how, you know, how he's been a beneficiary of privilege and how he's reconciled that, and encouraging other people to own their privilege and pay it forward.
Yeah. Let's talk about how we as South Africans can get on board and be an enabler of the initiative to allow it to grow, to truly reach the hearts and minds of all South Africans, because I'm assuming that that's part of the big why. We want to change minds, we want to change hearts, so that we can change the actions of South Africans every day and better our country. So how do we get on board?
You know what, I think you got to start, Kat, by just kind of, you know, letting go of your barriers, you know, just opening your mind and your, I guess, your heart up to listening to an alternative solution, message. For us, we're in the trenches. We're going around to corporate South Africa, which is really our hunting ground. But then we're going to schools, we're going to universities, we do a lot of pro bono work. We're actually going out and educating. I think that's really the biggest problem, is the miseducation in the space. So when you don't know some of these problems and barriers and roadblocks, very hard to get over them. So look, we've got a website, diversity101.co.za, which has got a ton of information on it. But we're also opening, like I said, to going into your spaces, coming into your schools, coming into your universities.
I want to answer that. I think stop and think. How do South Africans get involved? You know, just stop and think, you know, before you act. And bring humanity in the conversation. You know, we at loggerheads, you know, we sit on different sides of the aisles, and we kind of take humanity out of the equation. I think if I stop and think and see somebody and understand that that person's got a mother, that person's got a father, that person's got uncles, aunts, and it just kind of brings humanity into the picture. These aren't kind of difficult things to get, you know, to surmount. But when we take humanity out of the picture, then I see you, I just see you as a black guy, but I don't see you as
and a
father.
Target, a target perhaps for my anger, my 100% inadequacies prejudice. That I'm projecting
100%,
onto you.
100%, I don't see you as a father, I don't see you as a hardworking man, and when I interact with you on that level, the common denominators that we kind of bring us together are more than, you know, than stuff that drives us apart.
Yeah. Diversity101.co.za.
I love it.
You guys are true champions of South Africa, man. Yeah. And I pray all amounts of success and just upliftment for you guys, so that you can help us uplift the country.
Yeah. Thanks. Can I say one thing? We're speaking in Cape Town today at the waterfront at Catalyst Africa. Uh-huh. We're going to be doing our talks. If there's anyone in the Cape Town area, you can get tickets at the door. I think it's sold out online.
Yeah.
But go to catalystafrica.com. If you're in Cape Town, otherwise, catch us on Diversity 101. And thanks for having us.
Yeah. Danny Kay and Kabelo, thank you very much, guys.
Sweet, guys. Thank you.